Hi again, everybody. Welcome to the World Wrestling Federation. Jack Reynolds at ringside, along with Jesse the Body Ventura.
Well, Jack, I'm happy to be back here again, and I'm sure this week we're going to have plenty action for all the people out there.
Jimmy Superfly Snuka seeing action this week.
There's only one Superfly Snuka in the world, brother.
The Magnificent Morocco.
And his manager, the devious Mr. Fuji.
The combination of Big John Studd and Ken Patera.
Newly formed Big John Studd and Ken Patera, and we all know what they did to Andre the Giant.
On Blackjack Mulligan's Barbecue this week, the new World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions, the combination of Barry Windham and Mike Rotundo.
And there's always action and excitement in the barbecue.
Right now, let's go up to the ring, and let's get the introductions to our first bout.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match, one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first, from Hollywood, California, weighing 240 pounds, Goldie Rogers. His opponent, now about to enter the ring area, from the Fiji Islands, weighing 250 pounds, Jimmy Superfly Snuka!
Oh, listen to the excitement. Listen to the crowd, the roar of the crowd. As Jimmy Superfly Snuka about to enter the ring. There he goes, the Superfly man. His opponent, Goldie Rogers. Again, everybody, this is Jack Reynolds at ringside along with Jesse the Body Ventura.
Well, Jack, I'll tell you, there's only one Superfly Jimmy Snuka, and maybe we'll get a chance to see the Superfly climb up those ropes and fly for us tonight. It's something, Jack, that even I like to watch.
Your referee for this bout is Roger Francoeur. He's called for the bell. The match underway. Jimmy Snuka right now. Getting set, getting ready to go against Goldie Rogers.
The Superfly looks in phenomenal condition like he always is, and he looks rough and ready. Superfly Snuka versus Goldie Rogers. Both men eyeing each other. Collar elbow hookup. Goldie backing the Superfly into the corner. Superfly turns him around. And a real clean break by the Superfly.
Roger Francoeur asking for the break, getting a clean one. Jimmy Superfly Snuka.
There's always excitement in the fans. You see their reaction when they see the Superfly come out. Superfly with a top wrist lock, putting the pressure on Goldie Rogers. I really doubt if Goldie's going to be able to muscle his way out of there. Rogers is claiming Snuka pulled his hair. Now, I didn't see it. But the Superfly lets him go.
One thing about the Superfly, when he's in that ring, you never know what to expect from this man.
Well, Goldie Rogers claiming the Superfly took him down with a little bit of hair. I didn't see it, Jack, so I really don't know. And again, back to the top wrist lock for the Superfly on Goldie Rogers.
Both men seem to be stalking each other at this point in the match, Jesse.
And there's Rogers again claiming that Snuka pulled him by the hair, and Snuka telling the referee, no, I did not.
Come on, man, watch that hair.
And the Superfly lets him go.
I didn't see a hair pull. What's Rogers hollering about?
Well, he's using maybe a little ring psychology on the referee. If the referee's out of position, you know, Rogers convinced him that Snuka pulled his hair.
Francoeur seemed to be warning Jimmy Superfly Snuka.
Rogers backed Snuka into the ropes. Let's see if we get a clean break. No way. And Snuka responds with a big right hand, and all Rogers is going to do is bring the fire out Jimmy Superfly Snuka.
Boy, you can hear Rogers. You can hear Rogers hollering, yelling, screaming, doing just about everything but wrestling right now against Jimmy Superfly Snuka.
Well, I'll tell you, Jack, a lot of wrestlers have little different things they do in the ring, and Rogers seems to be a talker. He seems to continually be talking when he's in there. And now he's hitting Snuka with some big forearms to the back.
He seems to try to psych his opponent by using the mouth.
Well, a lot of wrestlers accomplish it, too. You know, everyone has their own style. Rogers is working the Superfly over now with a series of forearms. He's got the Superfly backing up. But here comes Snuka. Big headbutt. Down goes Rogers.
Oh, that stung. A tremendous headbutt in there by the Superfly man.
And a big chop. Laid that chop in there. Superfly picks up Rogers. Backbreaker.
Look out.
And he's going for the rope, Jack. Listen to the crowd. Superfly's measuring him. And this is a sight to behold. Look at this. Boom. That's all she writes, Jack.
Oh, caught him good. My goodness.
I think in all honesty, Jack, I'd be the only man in the world that could maybe get up from that.
What a tremendous shot in there by. There it is, number one. Jimmy Superfly Snuka as he came off that top ring rope. Let's get the official decision.
The winner of the match, Jimmy the Superfly Snuka.
As your winner, Jimmy Superfly Snuka. Right now, let's pick up the video replay once again and take a look at the tremendous move in there by the Superfly man.
There you can see the crowd's going crazy. The Superfly's measuring Goldie Rogers now. And look at this. He's got to come down from 10 to 12 feet in the air. Look at that. Nobody, Jack. Nobody's going to get up from that, I do believe.
Look how he caught Goldie Rogers.
One, two, and three.
Stand by for a World Wrestling Federation update coming your way.
Update this week focuses on Big John Studd. Big John Studd likes to think he's the biggest man in the world and takes no notice of the giant. A recent magazine showed Big John Studd with a big box. He likes everything big. He has Bobby Brain now working as his manager, guiding his future. He also has a cohort, Ken Patera. Let us see recently what these three people did, which they thought was rather amusing.
Just a little water. Okay.
What do you do to the water? What do you mean?
Just a little water. Just a little water. Not much, Ken. Huh? Just a little water.
Just a little water?
Yeah, just a little water. Uh-huh. Okay, that's enough. That's enough for right now.
Oh. Okay, now I need some shampoo here.
There.
Yeah. They're on table.
Poor man.
Get that side there.
Oh, no. What are you doing? Oh, come on.
Hey, anybody got any hot wax?
You know what I'm
saying? Big John Studd, Ken Patera, Bobby Heenan, they were obviously enjoying themselves at the expense of a volunteer. Well, if you volunteer for something, possibly it goes wrong. Big John Studd doesn't necessarily volunteer for things, but things could go wrong in a big, big way for him should the giant lay his hands on him.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match, one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first, from Kensington, New York, weighing 240 pounds, Paul Roma. Now I'd like to introduce the manager from Japan, Mr. Fuji. Mr. Fuji is leading to the ring from Sunset Beach, Hawaii, weighing 267 pounds, the magnificent Morocco.
The magnificent Morocco going up against Paul Roma. Morocco entering the ring along with his manager, Mr. Fuji. I'll tell you, this kid, this Paul Roma, very impressive looking young man.
Definitely, Paul Roma looks in terrific shape, and I believe he may test the magnificent Morocco pretty severely. But Morocco's a cagey veteran, and he's tough. Front face lock. Morocco going behind a little bit of amateur wrestling right here.
There he is, Mr. Fuji calling the shots.
And Morocco holding on to that front face lock. Roma's trying to get in deep and get a hold of that leg so he doesn't get turned over or taken over.
Mr. Fucci right now calling the shots.
There's a big hip toss by Morocco. And a big knee lift, and he's got Roma reeling a little bit. And he throws him out on the floor. No, he didn't quite get there.
Tremendous shot in there right now by the magnificent Morocco. Another knee to the back. And look at this. Fucci loves it.
Morocco going back, trying to sink that front face lock in again.
Our World Wrestling Federation cameras right on top of all the action this week.
Morocco again working that face lock, but Roma got out of it.
You know, Jesse, this young Paul Roma is giving the magnificent Morocco, Don Morocco, all he can handle.
Definitely. It's a rough, rough match right now. Morocco going back to that face lock. Roma's in tremendous condition, I think.
Looks like this young man is... Well, we talked about upsets before. This young man would be, what a tremendous upset this would be with Roma defeating Morocco.
Boom. And there's that reverse pile driver or shoulder breaker, whatever it is. And the magnificent Morocco going up on the ropes and coming off with a flying body press. And that's it.
You see, once again, I spoke too soon. As soon as I mentioned the word upset, Morocco went to work on young Paul Roma with a devastating maneuver in there. Some of the fans seem to, you can hear the cheers, you can hear the roar of the crowd as they approve the victory of the magnificent Morocco, along with his manager, Mr. Fucci.
The winner of the match, the magnificent Morocco.
There he goes, the magnificent Morocco, along with his manager, Mr. Fucci. All right, right now, let's pick up the replay. Let's pick up the video replay, Jess.
Here you see the magnificent Morocco turns him over. Now, this is kind of a combination of a reverse pile driver and a double shoulder breaker. Boom, right down on the back of his head. And you can see right there, he knocked Paul Roma senseless right there. The man is out, and the magnificent one knows he can climb the rope. Take his time because Roma's unconscious right now on the mat. Morocco pushes off, flattens himself out, and comes down all 267 pounds right on the chest of Paul Roma, and that's all she writes, Jack.
What a tremendous shot in there and a tremendous victory by the magnificent Morocco, along with manager Mr. Fucci. Coming up, a special interview right here on the World Wrestling Federation. Stand by.
Hello, everybody. I'm Freddie Biller for the World Wrestling Federation. I've been having a good time, and I always enjoy doing the commercials for the World Wrestling Federation, talking about in 30 seconds or 60 or whatever, the matches coming up in different areas all over the country. But this is going to be more fun. I have a chance now to meet and to introduce to you and find out more about in detail the exciting wrestlers themselves, the men who are responsible for making the World Wrestling Federation the number one wrestling association in the world, the one wrestling group that has the biggest stars wherever they step into the ring, unquestionably the outstanding wrestling organization in the world today. Now, SD Special Delivery Jones is from Philadelphia. Pleased to meet you and have you on. SD, you're a great wrestler. I watch you in action. You always give it everything you got. And what's your background? Tell us where you started out wrestling.
Oh, really? I started in Philadelphia. That's why they say I'm from Philadelphia. Real. Naturally, I was born in the Virgin Islands. I'm from down the Caribbean, you know, and there's a lot of people from the West Indies around who comes around and watch the matches. And they all know that I can get down, you know, but they'll be seeing more of me pretty soon because I'm getting myself together. I got a partner now. We're working on some things, and I'm going to get down.
You want to tell us who the partner is?
I think, no. I'll keep it quiet.
Oh, that's going to be something you'll spring on us later.
Yeah, you know, they got some mean guys around here. No one can talk about it like I do because the Big John Studd and Ken Patero, you know, everybody knows Rowdy Piper is the main thing around here with the mouth, you know.
Uh-huh.
But I tell you, I was in a tag team match just recently with the big man, Andre himself, and I got hurt. They threw me out. They got rid of me. Now they're doing things. The cut is here. I got busted up trying to save his hair. But they think it's all over. It's not done because it's going all over the place. And I'll be there. I'm going to watch them because the big man is coming back. He looks good looking with the haircut, though. I must tell you that.
He'll be coming back. He'll have you to help him if necessary. And S.D. Jones, come back and see us often, okay?
I'll be there.
That's S.D. Special Delivery Jones. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match, one ball with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first, from Morgan's Corner, Arkansas, weighing 285 pounds, Ted Grizzly. His opponent, from Montreal, Quebec, weighing 270 pounds, Luke Poirier.
There he is, Luke Poirier. He is a French star going against Ted Grizzly. Ted Grizzly, the rough, tough veteran. Referee Terry Yorkston right now calling for the bell. The match officially underway.
Well, Jack, I've never seen Luke Poirier at all, so I really don't know what to expect from him. I've seen Ted Grizzly, and I know he's a tough customer, and he's going to work on the young French-Canadian right now. Big forearms in the corner, got him tied up in the rope, shoots him into the rope, and catches him with a shoulder block, and I think it hurt both of them.
I understand that this Poirier is a protege of the fabulous Edouard Carpentier.
Poirier caught him with a clothesline off the rope, and he's got Grizzly rocking and reeling now.
Or Carpentier, whatever way you want to pronounce it.
Hits him up. Body slam.
He's a big man in that ring, this Luke Poirier.
Yeah, but I can tell he's young and he's a bit inexperienced because he's not staying on top of Grizzly. You've got to stay on top of your opponent.
Right now, Poirier trying to take control of this bout. Grizzly right now. What a tremendous knee lift to the midsection by Ted Grizzly.
Grizzly drops an elbow on him. Both guys are sucking a little air right now.
Boy, Grizzly caught him just right coming off of the ring rope there.
Grizzly goes to an arm bar now, and he's working on that arm. Grinding down on the arm in the shoulder area.
Took the cagey veteran a little time to get going, but he seems to be in control of this spot right now, Grizzly.
Hitting him with some big forearms. Punch to the head.
That's got to be a mistake for Grizzly to be antagonizing his opponent using the tremendous strong in attendance this week as an ally.
Grizzly's got Poirier stunned on the ropes, but he blocked that one, and he's blocking them all and comes back with a shot of his own right to the heart, another one to the heart. And a shot to the side of the head. Down goes Grizzly.
Oh, he caught him with a tremendous right hand to the side of the jaw, and Grizzly went down.
And it looks like, what do we got here? A reverse backbreaker.
Wow.
Tremendous strength right there to pick a man of Grizzly's size up like that. And the match is over. He submitted. Grizzly has submitted. What a backbreaker.
Referee Terry Yorkston has called for the bell. Boy, this young Frenchman really coming up with a tremendous move on Ted Grizzly. Unbelievable. Here's the official decision.
The winner of the match, Luke Poirier.
Luke Poirier. Wow. Oh, we got to take a look at the video replay once again and watch Poirier going against Ted Grizzly.
This is a unique style of a backbreaker right here. I haven't seen it applied like this. Tremendous strength. Look at that. Lifting Ted Grizzly up probably 280 or 290 pounds and causing him to submit.
There's referee Terry Yorkston calling for the bell. Boy, I'll tell you, this young Frenchman, he put on quite a tremendous showing here on the World Wrestling Federation this week.
Well, I'll tell you, Jack, he looks a little green. He looks a little bit like a rookie. He needs some polish, but he's definitely got the strength there.
This is Jack Reynolds at ringside along with Jesse the Body Ventura. More exciting World Wrestling Federation action coming your way right after this interview.
You get a lot of response from wrestling fans because when they watch and they get into it, and the wrestling fans who watch the World Wrestling Federation are like that, you hear their comments and it's interesting. Now, Brutus Beefcake has caused as much controversy and real public response as any man I've watched in action in the past several months. And his manager, the astute, luscious Johnny Valiant's with us. Your man Beefcake's causing a response and a sensation everywhere he goes.
Well, that's an astute observation on your part, Freddie Miller. I mean, it's an obvious one, it's an honest one, and it's a sincere one, and it's a benevolent one. That's what we see in my eye. You're right, pal. You've been watching TV, I take it.
Well, always. I think the wrestling
Well, you didn't watch it on the radio, so yeah. Obviously you've seen it by way of the silver screen, right?
Right, that's true.
Communication. There's a communication
so
going here.
You talk so pretty.
Well, you know, the old manager here used to be a Philadelphia lawyer. I got Bernie DiGiulio out of the slammer a few times.
You're going to bury me with
it. Close it on it, too.
Wait a minute. I want to talk to Brutus. Does he speak?
Huh?
Does he speak?
What do you mean, does he speak?
May I interview him?
Which is an all-night talk show. You go through me if you want to talk to that man. Does that go
for anybody out there?
I want to shut your mouth. Listen, what do you have? I get done with you. I put you back in the car wash where you were a lifeguard.
Hold the microphone.
Let me tell you something right now. Anybody wants to do any kind of a business deal, you go through JV, Daddy-O. You understand? This is a one-way street right here. This is the feed belt right here. You stand here like a Statue of Liberty and hold that piece of the wire, and I'll take over this thing. You understand? I'm bringing this guy. He's been one of those times. You see what that stands for back there? WWF. That don't stand for one. And Ralphie from Roanoke. That stands for WWF. And when you see Lester Johnny Vine, yeah. You can see this man right here. Right here. And that's the way it is, and that's the way Lester Johnny Vine's going to take it right on down and bring it right out. And let me tell you something right now. It's Brutus Beefcake. 265 pounds of twisted steel. He's talking. He's talking.
He's got a roll now, Daddy.
We'll be back.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match, one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first, from Providence, Rhode Island, weighing 240 pounds, Pete Pompey. First, I'd like to introduce the manager, Luscious Johnny Valiant. Now introducing, weighing 270 pounds, the Spoiler.
There he is, the Spoiler, along with manager Luscious Johnny Valiant, going against Pete Pompey, the referee for this bout. Right now, the match getting underway. With the Spoiler parting away on Pete Pompey. Valiant out of the ring versus Johnny, both men going at it.
And I'll tell you something, Jack, there's no referee.
By goodness, you're right, Jesse.
The Spoiler uses the ropes. I'll tell you, the Spoiler is an expert at the ropes. Picking up Pete Pompey and again taking him over to the ropes. And look at Luscious Johnny taking pictures on the sideline.
All right, referee Roger Francoeur right now pulling both men apart. The Spoiler and Pete Pompey. The Spoiler in command of this bout right now.
And look, Jack, Luscious Johnny taking pictures. He's taking pictures from ringside as the Spoiler's working Pete Pompey over. Look at Luscious Johnny. Got him! Pompey pushing the Spoiler in the corner and going for some shoulder blocks. Pompey collar elbow hookup. Spoiler goes to a top wrist lock. Reversed into a hammer lock by Pete Pompey.
You're going to wind up with NBC News. You got in my way.
Johnny Valiant complaining bitterly at ringside as he's running around with a camera. Very expensive looking camera. It looks to be taking pictures of the spoiler. Look at him hollering at referee Roger Francoeur.
He wants him to get out of the way, Jack, because he's impeding him taking pictures of the spoiler. They're obviously not taking Pete Pompey too serious. The spoiler with a reverse chin lock on him, standing behind him, stretching the neck out right now. And there you can see Luscious is still taking pictures. Into the ropes. Pompey ducks the elbow, but gets caught by a clothesline, and down he goes. And a big elbow to the side of the neck. Spoiler picks him up, and there goes the claw. This may be it, Jack. The spoiler's putting the claw in, and look at Luscious Johnny taking pictures.
He loves it. He loves it. Right on top of all the action, along with our World Wrestling Federation cameras.
Get out of my way!
Valiant calling the shots as the spoiler continues his assault. Wait a minute. Referee Roger Francoeur has called for the bell.
He got the three count. The spoiler put the claw on, and Pompey's shoulders went to the mat for a three count. And the spoiler's refusing to break the hold, giving that little added dimension of pain.
Right now, Valiant, look at that. Valiant taking a picture of referee Francoeur. There's the spoiler. Boy, you talk about action. You talk about confusion.
Well, I'll tell you, Jack, that's one of the strangest matches I've ever seen.
Right now, let's go to the ring.
The winner of the match,
the spoiler, along with this very, very happy manager, Luscious Johnny Valiant.
There you see the spoiler dropped a big elbow on him, and it's now setting him up for his claw. There goes the claw hold. Now, here's what you missed, Jack. When he puts the claw on, you'll see Pete Pompey's shoulders go down to the mat if we have time, and the referee called the three count.
Well, here I am on the A-Team, I suppose one of the most successful shows ever, possibly in the history of shows. And, of course, I'm creeping up on the back of Mr. T. I can tell you that because it's got it written right here on the back of your chair. Mr. T, hello. I know you can hear me, and I don't mean to bother you. My name's Hot Rod. Of course, you know who I am. And I know who you are because your name's written on the back of the chair, and I'm assuming that that's there so you don't get lost. They told me to come down here and talk to you because what you got here is this great, successful show. Then you guys are portraying these bad guys, and they wanted to know, since I am a bad guy actual in real life, and I do beat people folks up for a living, but they wanted to know, they kind of wanted to know, how does it feel to be portraying someone like myself?
Well, you ain't nothing, man.
Why, because I don't have a chair with my name on it? Excuse me, I don't need one, because I can take any chair I want to take. I ain't nothing. What are you talking about?
Hey, man, I seen what you've been doing on TV, man. You've been fighting them little wimps. What I do is
wimps,
for real.
Wimps, what?
That's right, wimps.
Oh, what are you talking about, wimps? I'll let this take a look at you. Wimps, let me see, wimps. The only wimp I can think of is Cyndi Lauper's manager, Dave Wolf. He's a wimp.
Yeah, speaking about Cyndi Lauper, she happened to be my friend. We go out together sometimes with dinner. I like her singing. And I heard about what you did to her in Madison Square Garden. I don't like that at all.
Oh, you don't like
that? That's why you call yourself tough, because you can punch on a lady?
Wait. I am an equal opportunist. Let's put it this way. Let's take a look at you. Here you are. You shaved your head on both sides. She dyed her orange. What you're doing is you're supporting all these wonderful children. Now, how can they look up to you with you looking like that, her with long hair? The children of America today must be sick to look at someone. Hey, I'll tell you, you mess with me, T, I'll put an X on your name, brother.
Get him back. Now you can get.
Ladies and gentlemen, this will be a tag team match. One fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first, from the Pocono Mouth, in Jim Thorpe, Pennsylvania, weighing 251 pounds, A.J. Petrucci. His partner, from parts unknown, weighing 225 pounds, Mr. X. Their opponent, first from Oakland, California, weighing 245 pounds, the former All-Star with the Saskatchewan Rough Riders, George Wells. His partner, from Calgary, Alberta, weighing 245 pounds, Bret Hart.
Back with more action here on the World Wrestling Federation, the combination of Bret Hart and George Wells going against A.J. Petrucci and Mr. X. Your referee for this bout is John Bonello. There's the bell. The match officially underway.
Well, I'll tell you, George Wells, another ex-football player. And he just gives Mr. X a shoulder block that sent him flat on his back. I don't think Mr. X needs to play football against George Wells.
Wells with a boot. Mr. X reeling right now as referee John Bonello checks in.
I'll tell you, that kick looked like a field goal from 50 yards. Wells shoots X into the ropes, drops down again, and a big hip toss. Down goes Mr. X. Beautiful move on the part of George Wells.
Good movement there by George Wells.
And a beautiful flying head scissors. And Mr. X has had enough and tags out to A.J. Petrucci. And Petrucci trying to slow things down a little bit.
Big man from Jim Thorpe, Pennsylvania, A.J. Petrucci in there right now against Big George Wells.
It's kind of a Canadian connection here. George Wells played his pro football up in Canada, and Bret Hart standing on the ring apron from the famous Hart wrestling family out of Calgary, Canada. Petrucci catches Wells with a shot to the midsection and knee. Wells shoots him into the ropes. Big shoulder block by Petrucci. And what a nip up by Wells. Leapfrogs him and kicks him in the stomach. And a big chop, and down goes Petrucci.
Bret Hart yet to see action in this bout. It's been all of George Wells so far.
And another beautiful flying head scissors. And a headlock takeover, and Wells cinches down on that headlock on A.J. Petrucci.
Nice takedown there by George Wells. There's a tag, and here comes Bret Hart, the Canadian star.
Bret Hart, like I said, out of the famous Hart family, father Stu Hart. Big forearm, picks Petrucci up, body slam. Leg drop right on the neck and throat area. Picks up Petrucci again. And a reverse backbreaker. Beautiful move.
Oh, what a tremendous shot in there by Bret Hart. A.J. Petrucci right now. Oh!
And a big side suplex. Tag off to George Wells. Bret Hart looked real impressive in there.
He's a fast comer, that Bret Hart.
They got Petrucci rocking and reeling, and there's a big shoulder block. And Petrucci's down. This could be it, Jack. And it is.
Johnny Bonello with a three count. Well, I'll tell you, you talk about excitement. You talk about a dynamic tag team combination. What a tandem. The tandem of Bret Hart and George Wells. And they are the winners of this exciting bout. Okay, let's get the official decision right now.
The winners of the match, the team of Bret Hart and George Wells.
There they are. Let's pick up the replay right now, Jesse.
And here's the beautiful side suplex by Bret Hart. Big suplex gets Petrucci up. Petrucci weighs about 280, and look at that. Wham! And that's all she wrote. George Wells just put icing on the cake after that suplex by Bret Hart.
We'll be back with more exciting action here on the World Wrestling Federation right after we take this commercial break.
Introducing first, from Charlotte, North Carolina, weighing 238 pounds, Rick Quickdraw McGraw. His partner, from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, weighing 237 pounds, SD, Special Delivery
I can't say that because they do. They do. But Big John Studd in the ring right now.
But he's definitely got Bobby the Brain Heenan, Big John Studd, strongman Ken Patera. A bit worried, I believe.
He's got his eye on that combination, that trio. After what they did to him, for the attack that they did to Andre, cutting his hair, humiliating the man, attacking the man. Andre has got his eyes all the time on Studd, Patera, and Heenan.
You see, the referee is telling Andre, he's got to go back to the dressing room.
I guess that Studd and Patera and Heenan is objecting. They're objecting vehemently right now as to Andre being at ringside. They don't want him there.
Well, can you really blame him, Jack? What a distraction. That's a 500-pound distraction outside the ring.
That is true, Jesse. Look at the weasel. He is up in arms. He wants no part of Andre, in or out of the ring.
You can hear the fans chanting, weasel, weasel, weasel. And I know for a fact that Bobby the Brain Heenan does not like to be called weasel. And I don't feel that he is a weasel, Jack.
He's
a top-of-the-line manager. He manages winners and should not be treated and called weasel.
Andre will never forget. He will never forget what Patera, Studd, and Heenan did. He will never let them live it down. And until this man gets his revenge, and you know, Jesse, sooner or later, he's going to wind up getting his revenge.
Well, it was funny because the night it happened, Andre was teamed up with SD Special Delivery
Jones. That's exactly right. Right on the money, babe. Listen to the crowd hollering, weasel, weasel.
Is definitely excited, but I believe Andre's leaving now. Bobby Heenan, Bobby the brain that he is, has managed to get Andre the Giant back to the dressing room. They don't call him the Brain for nothing, Jack.
The action continues here on the World Wrestling Federation. John Studd, Ken Patera, SD Special Delivery Jones, and Rick Quick Draw McGraw. What a match.
We got Patera and Jones, and Jones starts right off with an arm drag on strongman Ken Patera. You can see Andre the Giant has definitely shook these two up.
It's hard to have a match. It's hard to concentrate on professional wrestling when you got some 7-foot-4 goons stalking behind you. I don't bother anybody. I'm a licensed manager. He should have been sent back just like he was. Justice did prevail.
Well, Bobby Heenan has a point there. Andre the Giant is not a manager. He is not a licensed manager. You have to have a license to be a manager in order to be at ringside.
In the meantime, in the center of the ring, Big John Studd pounding away. Now Patera on SD Special Delivery Jones.
And it seems like Studd and Patera have got their act together now, and they're working SD over.
Boy, referee Terry Yorkston, he's got his hands full.
Big body slam and a big elbow drop by Patera. There's a cover, but only a one count. SD's a pretty tough customer.
SD right now trying to get over to tag his partner, Rick Quick Draw McGraw, but nothing doing. Let's see if he can do it.
Patera puts on a vicious bear hug, but SD's fighting it, and he headbutts and gets out of it. Underneath him, there's the tag to Quick Draw McGraw. Big right hand. Drop kick, and down goes Ken Patera. Another right hand. And Quick Draw's working over strongman Ken Patera. Big turnbuckle. And Patera catches him with a clothesline.
Ah, what a tremendous move in there by strongman Ken Patera as he caught Rick Draw McGraw.
And there's a big side suplex and a tag to Big John Studd.
Here comes
nearly
the big
seven
man.
Feet, nearly 7 feet, 370-odd pounds. Studd picks up McGraw. Rams him in the turnbuckle, and you can hear the crowd chanting, Andre, Andre.
There's a press. Three count.
And Studd gets Quick Draw McGraw.
Boy, you talk about excitement. You talk about the action. You're seeing it here on the World Wrestling Federation, featuring the superstars of professional wrestling. Unbelievable. Let's telescope to the ring right now and try to get the official decision.
The winners of the match, the team of Ken Patera and Big John Studd.
There they are. Oh, what a combination.
Well, I'll tell you something, Jack. The presence of Andre the Giant seemed to shake up Studd and Patera at the start of the match, but they got it together and were awesome. Here you see Big John Studd. He's got quick draw, Rick McGraw right where he wants him, a big backbreaker, and 370-odd pounds covering quick draw, Rick McGraw for the three count.
Referee Terry Yorkson with a three count. There's Bobby Heenan. Oh, he loves it. Look how quick he's up into that ring. Back with more World Wrestling Federation action. But first, this important interview.
they say all kinds of things, but they're afraid to really come and say it to my face. I sit here with my back to you because I figured possibly somebody out there would at least like a chance. Hulk Hogan said something about it's the size of the fight and the dog. I ain't never been to compare to no dog, because I don't come from no dog. They says, you kick Cindy Lauper, and how could you kick a woman? I says, you know, I'm an equal opportunist. You know, a woman hits me, I'll knock her out. It doesn't matter to me. He says, you took that poor old fat Love Lou Albano, the captain. Remember the little tidy bowl, man? I got a job. I got a little ship for you, Captain. Remember in the bowl where the boat used to go around? I'm supposed to feel bad because I kicked accidentally this woman that grabbed a hold of me, and I nail this big fat slob who has been calling you all kinds of names for years, and now because he does something good for muscular dystrophy, everybody's behind him. And then I look over, and this skinny little geek, just this skinny little guy, who's Wendy, or Cindy Lauper, whatever her name is, her boyfriend, whatever she is. I took him and I power slammed him, and here comes New York's finest in Madison Square Garden. Policemen turn in their badges when I come to town. And I look over and I see that Jimmy Snuka, he can't run down, you see, because my bodyguard Ace is there. I love my bodyguard. And Ace has got all kinds of weapons in his hand. He's got chairs, and he's watching my back. And all of a sudden, I see Dick Clark. And Dick Clark comes and takes two steps towards me. Like he thought he was going to do something to me. Him selling all them facial products. Can you imagine him do something to Hot Rod himself, Roddy Piper? The only thing you'd be good for after that is maybe playing the organ deep down in some opera house. You remember the Phantom of the Opera? The one with the face all twisted around. And they say, Roddy, how could you be so bad? And I say, you know, even at my worst, I'm best. And while my bodyguard is doing his job and he's keeping Jimmy Snuka, the super fly away legend of wrestling, in sneaks Hulk Hogan, like he's going to do something to me, huh? In sneaks Hulk Hogan in all his glory, but did you notice when he come in and he looked eye to eye, all of a sudden he stopped just for a moment, because he really wasn't sure whether he should come or not. I don't blame you. I am the legend killer. If you're drowning in a river, I'm the kind of guy that'll throw you a rope. But I'll throw you both ends.
Wrestling Federation this week.
Jack, every week, It just seems there's more and more excitement all the time. It's building and building and building.
Next week, Tony Atlas, Mr. USA, going to be seeing some action.
Yep, Tony Atlas. I know the man real well. Always plenty of action.
David Sammartino also in action next week.
The son of the living legend trying to follow in his dad's footsteps.
Intercontinental Wrestling Heavyweight Champion Greg the Hammer Valentine.
With Tito Santana chasing Valentine at every turn.
Junkyard Dog and also Jimmy Superfly Snuka.
And, of course, we'll have Mulligan's Barbecue.
Right. His special guest next week will be the combination of Ken Patera, John Studd, and Bobby Heenan. Until next week, this is Jack Reynolds along with Jesse the Body Ventura. We'll see you next week.
And you, World Wrestling Federation Heavyweight Champion, the Incredible Hulk Hogan!
Weeknights at XNE, we have your comedy connection. Beginning at 5, we'll connect you to two fun families with 8 Is Enough and Different Strokes. Then at 6:30, it's an alien connection to Mork and Mindy, followed by another look at Different Strokes. At 7:30, you're connected to rock and roll comedy at WKRP in Cincinnati.